Namaskar and good afternoon. Today, we will look at another pharma company, RPG Life Sciences. It's a part of the RPG Enterprises and is an integrated pharmaceutical company operating in both domestic and international markets in the branded formulations, global generics and synthetic API space. The company is research based, producing a wide variety of quality affordable medicines. Now the management consists of Harshvardhan Goenka, chairman of the RPG Life Sciences. He is also the chairman of the RPG Group. Then managing director is Yugal Sikri. So there are three units manufacturing both APIs and formulations. The employees are 1160 plus. There are three business verticals. First one is domestic formulations. It comprises mass and specialty businesses. The mass business is also a mass specialty business with strong textbook brands. Very famous brands are there. Then specialty business is a segment leading nephro business with new therapies onco and euro under development. Onco and euro are under development. Then manufacturing in it is the unit is at Ankaleshwar. In-house also is there, outsourced also is there. The revenue is 196 crores. Then international formulations, domestic formulations, international formulations, APIs, three segments, three divisions. International formulations, main markets are Europe, Canada, Southeast Asia and Africa, mainly immunosuppressants. Revenue is 67 crores. Here this also manufactured at Ankaleshwar unit. It is a WHO and EU GMP approved unit. APIs for both the captive and external sales. This is also WHO and approved unit at Navi Mumbai. So overall manufacturing facilities are WHO approved are there. One is at Navi Mumbai, another is Ankaleshwar unit 1 and yet another is Ankaleshwar unit 2. The RPG Life Sciences is manufacturing so many products already. Many popular products are under development like sodium valproate, amino caproic acid, azathio prime, mycophenolate, mofetil. So for all these andas are being prepared. Now the RPG Life Sciences is a transformation journey. There is always a lot of transformation going on. Biotech division has been sold off, several brands have been acquired, specialties are being strengthened, ANDA filing is quickened, US FDA approvals are coming, portfolio is being cleaned up, growth is being restored. Why growth is being restored? See, 3 years, FY 16, 17, 18 were great years with good development. FY 19 was a little poor year after three strong years. So now profitability is to be uplifted. Now that is being done. Now the focus is on investment in formulations business. In domestic, in FY 19, there was a setback in mass formulations. There are challenges in the mass business like market slowdown in some represented segments, high reliance on trade, low focus on RX generation, high in-market inventories, expiries and returns, so many challenges were there. So there was a degrowth of 21% and there was a loss in this segment after 2 years of profits. But the gross margins were maintained at over 55%. Now, FY19 was a rather poor year, therefore some challenges have arisen and some actions are being initiated to face these challenges. Now, change in business leadership. So, across the line, people who are not performing, they have gone out, and there is a leadership change. Renewed focus on RX generation, discounts and promotion optimization, product portfolio augmentation, so many things are going on. Now, internal formulations. There also there was a setback in regulated market business. So, there also there are challenges. Regulated market business setback was due to one key customer, Teva, who decided to drop the product due to internal reprioritization. They had, Teva had their own priorities, therefore they have dropped the Teva product off RPG. But that is as far as formulations, etc., domestic, etc. Now, APIs. APIs continues to be a strong cash cow. Consistent performance for the last 3 years. Quinfamide is the key product, and Latin America is the key market for quinfamide. So, the challenges are limited customers and limited molecular base, legacy plant. The plant which they are having at Ankaleshwar, etc. for APIs, that is not capable of upgradation to regulated market standards like US. So, some actions are being taken, manufacturing strategy optimization, certain things are being outsourced. Manufacturing is initiated with US FDA approved API suppliers. They are expecting strong growth and profitability now, good demand momentum for exports. Actually, while the FY19 was a poor year, improvements were visible in the second half. Now, what is the strategy forward? They want to focus, continue to focus on formulations, downstream integration for the formulations business, selected market expansion, and the strategies will be using own technology, but using in-house manufacturing and outsourced manufacturing for own technology also. Now, they are aiming at above market growth with strong profitability for the current year. It is visible now already. Let us see when we come to results. So, the focus is on growing the sales and entry into regulated markets and B2C markets. So, the strategy, further strategy is niche products are under development. They will be in the pipeline. Then USFD approval of the plant that they are taking. When it comes, US sales will pick up. Now let us look at the results. Net sales for Q2 are 98 crores, whereas for Q1 it was 94 crores, and Q2 of last year it was 90 crores. So from 90 crores, it went up to 94 crores in Q1, and in Q2, 98.49 crores actually. So 9% year-on-year growth and 5% quarter-on-quarter growth. Now, interest costs are stable. Actually, they have come down from 1 crore to 0.36 crores. Then profit before tax has gone up by 288% from 3 crores to 12 crores. 12 crores. Then taxes has gone up a little, but not much. Now, net profit from 2.16 crores in September 18 quarter, that is Q2 of last year, from 2.16, it has gone up to 8 crores in Q1 of this year and 10 crores in Q2 of the year. So, 352% growth year on year and 17% growth quarter on quarter. I will repeat once more, net sales have grown 9% year-on-year and 5% quarter-on-quarter. Profit before tax has grown 288% year-on-year and 11% quarter-on-quarter. Net profit has grown 352% year on year and 17% quarter on quarter. EPS also has grown like that, 5.91 now. Last year it was 1.31 only. So from 1.31 rupees to 5.91 rupees, it is quite high. The face value of the share is 8 rupees. So on 8 rupees, 5.91 is reasonably good. It is growing. So the latest market price is around 278. The volumes are in lakhs, so there is no problem. Price earning on annualized EPS and current price is 11.8. 11.8 is not low, not high. But if the trend in net profit growth continues, if the challenges faced are yielding good results, this 11 may come down to 4 or 5 also next quarter. See, it is not possible to tell definitely, but if the trend continues, the growth will continue and price earning ratio also will fall. Profits will rise, price will rise, but price earning is likely to remain stable or fall. The 52-week low was 55 and 52-week high is 319. Current price is at 278. 55 is low, 319 is high, and 278 is the current price. So there is scope for growth, no, especially because the EPS has grown, net profit have grown from 2.16 to 9.77. So 352% growth is there in the net profit. Therefore, it is likely to grow. As and when the market stabilizes, it is likely to grow. Face value is 8 rupees. Now, if you take trailing 12 months, EPS is said to be 15. I have not calculated. It is money control calculation 15. But it's likely. But what I do is I take the latest quarter multiplied by 4. I assume that the next coming 3 quarters or etc. will be progress only, because the management is expecting progress. There is no dismal comment from the management. FY19 was a failure. After 3 years of great development, FY19 was a poor year. But in FY19 also H2 was progressing. Now the progress is much better. In FY20, first quarter itself is EPS 5 and second quarter is EPS 5.91, that is 6. So if it goes like this, it could be 6, 7 like that in the coming quarters, and EPS is likely to be more than 20, much more than 20 in the current year. So I expect good times for RPG Life Sciences in the current year and going forward. They have taken a lot of steps to neutralize the challenges that they are facing. Thank you for listening. I will be back with you with another good company. Wait for me. I always select good companies, reasonably good companies. You have seen now profits have gone up like anything, and sales also have gone up reasonably, but profitability, profit margin has gone up very well during the last 2 quarters. And compared to Q1 also, Q2 is a development. Therefore, RPG Life Sciences, I expect that they will perform better in the coming quarters also. Thank you for listening.